Coach TV. I'm Joe X, the body coach, and I've got a special guest. It's Tom from Techno Gym, and you are a
kettlebell master trainer.
He's come down today to the BCHQ. We've done an awesome technique workshop, and now we're going to go for an 18-minute full body cardio and kettlebell workout, yeah? So basically, we're going to do 30 seconds on the exercise, 30 seconds rest. It's three rounds of six moves, so 18 minutes in total. Make sure you've done a warm-up. First exercise, Tom, what we're going to do, make sure you quickly demo the first move.
Two-handed swing. Snap the hips through. Nice and tight through your upper back.
30 seconds on the kettlebell swing. Second move is going to be
hand release burpee.
So chest to ground, releasing the hands, jumping up, hands above the head, feet off the ground. That's your second move. And then third move.
Single arm clean and press. So weak side first, up into the clean, push press, come back down, and repeat.
15 seconds per arm. Fourth exercise.
Straight to a high knee run.
High knee sprint. That's going to be really tough. Get your heart rate up. Number five.
Single arm reverse lunge. So go on your weak side first, stick the kettlebell on your front rack, you're going to alternate reverse lunge, and then 50, after 15
seconds. Yeah, 15 seconds, you change the arms, same again, alternate. Brilliant. And then the final move is going to be
push up.
Push up, yeah?
Old tool push up, arms straight to top, elbows coming behind, chest touch floor, try and keep your legs off the floor.
So it's six moves, 30 seconds on each move with a 30 second rest. We're going to do the whole thing three rounds ago, so it's an 18 minute workout. You're going to hear the beeper every 30 seconds. You're going to start off then with the kettlebell swing, yeah? So nice strong back. Here we go, 5 seconds. Let's go. So I'm swinging a 16 kilogram. What you got there, mate?
We've got 20, Joe.
So it's all about choosing a weight that, you know, you feel the muscles working, but don't overdo it. If it's just your first time, choose a weight that's comfortable for you, but also challenging. Right, good. So we've got 10 seconds on the clock. And this is really working your hamstrings and your glutes. You've got to drive through the hips, activate those muscles, hit the posterior chain. Brilliant. So, little 30 second rest. Next move is going to be the
hand release burpee.
Hand release burpee. So, basically, what you're going to do, chest to the ground, lift your hands up and up, yeah? As many as you can for 30 seconds. So,
find an easy pace as well. If you really want to push yourself today, go quick. If you want to...
He's a CrossFitter, right? But I'm going to try and keep up with him, but this guy's a beast. I've just seen his rig and he's absolutely stacked. He's a unit, mate.
Guilty.
Right. He's an absolute unit. Up, right. So 30 seconds on this one. Chest to ground, lift his hands up. He's just going to get you down. Really low.
Yes, it should.
So, little rest, we're going to be down on the floor for some press ups. That'll be round one. We've got two more to go, yeah? I'm sorry, I put that wrong.
Reverse lunge.
Landed, then the press ups. So, let's wrap them up. Left arm then.
Clean, not dominant side first. Try and keep that front rack. You're going to be unstable as well. So, try and stay really upright.
Other arm out, is that right? Doing that?
Yeah, just to balance you out. And then, if you can, get that back knee as low to the ground as possible. Nice big stride. Time for one more. Let's go side on to the tip side.
It really does make your body work. Your single dumbbell, sorry, single kettlebell. Nothing in. Good step, right. Brilliant, well done guys. So, next move then is press ups. If you can't do a full press up, by all means, on the knees is fine. Try and get as many as you can down if you can, full press up, then maybe drop to your knees, your technique. If you fail on the technique.
Yeah, just pace it up. You've used your shoulders a lot already in the workout, so they're going to be fatigued. Doesn't make you a bad person if you can't stay up on your toes for 10 seconds.
Yeah, do what you can. I'll tell you what, we're going to do four rounds. I'm so glad we broke that board and did three. Yeah, we're thinking four rounds or three, and I'm thinking, when I write work and then I hate not finishing it. So once I write it, I'm real, and I have to finish it. Good, right, 10 seconds for this one. Nice strong press. Extend. 5, 4, 3, 2. Right, so round one, feeling good. So you know what's coming now. Grab a quick drink. We're going again in 20 seconds. Those kettlebell swings. So I'm really glad that Tom's come down, so I appreciate your time, mate.
It's a pleasure.
He's improved my technique because I didn't need to work on it. And now I feel like I can give a lot more instruction and demo things better, so I'll be doing more kettlebell workouts on the YouTube channel. Right, here we go.
Alright, round two. Swings.
Let's go side on. I can see it works. But just explain the technique for this one and tell us what we're working.
So hips back towards both of the wall behind you, or think about driving your hips back towards the wall, making sure that as we snap our hips through, we're going to get lots of hamstring and glute activation. As we come to the top, try to keep our shoulders as tight as possible. Abs tight, glutes tight. I'll tell you what, Joe, talking through that makes it a lot harder, mate.
Yeah, I'm feeling the burn. If you really are feeling the glutes and the arms and the hamstrings, once you do connect with that muscle, that's a brilliant exercise for working the bum. You combine that with the lunges, you're going to really get a nice strong boost at it. Right. Oh, God. The burpees now. Again, 30 seconds on this. If you need a bit more rest, take another 10 seconds, but try and get in and finish all the rounds. So, hands down, release them, and up. Hands down, release the hands, and up. Chest, hands, up.
Ideally, you try and keep going on the vertical. So you just need to slow your pace. Back, good place to breathe.
Yeah, we're not going at it here.
Almost like all the way down, you can recover. Breathe.
What, like I'm saying that here, recover?
Yeah, that's the best recovery position.
Oh, right, yeah. Yeah, we are going at a fast pace on that, so don't feel like you're not. If you're not keeping up, you're not doing well, because that's. Going somewhere now. Right. Next move.
Clean and press. So again, high skill. More fatigue now. Technique could get a little bit sloppy. So really stay on point. Snap the hips through. Big elbow towards the ceiling.
So left arm first.
Nice big catch. And use your legs to help. Help push press. It's definitely a bit more technical this one. I'll think about it a little bit more.
We've got 5 seconds on the clock. Last couple of reps.
push-ups. Thank you. to start to slow down in that last five. You've got to dig deep, you've got to push hard in the last five, because that's the one that's counting, that's the real effort. That's when you need it. That's when you make the challenge, that's when you really start to see difference in the body when you push into that little red zone. Red zone or black zone?
Red zone.
Red zone. Lunges. Practice up clean.
Peace.
Welcome back to the Body Coach TV. I'm Joe, the Body Coach, and I've got a special guest. It's Tom from Techno Gym, and you are a